How do you manage these compound fractures? As I said in the beginning, the compound fractures are likely to be accompanied with other injuries also. Number one, there will be lot of bleeding sometimes. Three, the injury to nerves and vessels may damage further, and skin may not be there, and that's why sooner we do it, the better it is. So first part of the management is always first aid. What do you do in the casualty or as soon as you see the patient? First aid is immediately assess whether the patient is in shock. Shock can be neurogenic and then can be due to circulatory problems. What do you mean by shock from this? Here, pulses pulse is rapid, BP is slow, limbs will be cold. Now what happens if it is a neurogenic shock? Either way, the effects are the same. This one, because of the pain, patient will go into neurogenic shock. If it is loss of blood, patient will go into circulatory shock. So you have got to treat, first thing that you have got to do in first aid is start treatment for shock. If there is circulatory failure, if you feel, then starts IV fluids, plasma expanders, and then blood if needed. And if the patient is in neurogenic shock, you have got to give sedation or pain relievers like analgesics, you have got to give them and sedate the patient so that there will not be any pain due to shock. Then after taking care of the shock, if the wound is there, cover the wound with sterile band. Wash the wound with pyridine solution. Now this is the best thing, pyridine. Use the pyridine solution and then cover with sterile gauze. Three, pressure bandage. Pressure bandage will take care of the bleeding to a large extent. Fourth, splint the fracture site. Splint fracture. So these are the minimum things that you have got to do as a first aid. Wash the wound with pyridine and then cover with sterile gauze, apply pressure bandage and splint fracture. In addition to that, you have got to give antibiotic, then anti-gas gangrene serum followed by tetanus toxoid, a booster dose to see that the patient doesn't end up with either gas gangrene or tetanus, which are life threatening problems. After doing this first aid, now definitive treatment has to be done. It consists of, if necessary, taking x-rays and all, confirm the diagnosis, X-rays, more often the fractures are visible, but still for record purposes you have got to take a radiographic picture and then preserve them for future litigations, not only for that and future comparison also it will be useful. So just because the fractures are seen, we should not forget about the radiograph. So if always it should be followed by X-rays as a part and then only shift the patient to the emergency theater. In emergency theater, we do two things. One is debridement. Two is treatment of the fracture proper if possible. Otherwise, give some temporary external fixation. Excision of all dead and devitalized . This is a very important thing, because in a compound fracture there may be some dead tissues or devitalized tissues. If you let them stay there in that position, then it's going to be a good nidus or source of infection, and the bacteria settle down nicely in the dead and devitalized tissues. Because there is no circulation, that's why the tissues are dead and devitalized, and that's why whatever antibiotics we are going to give, they're not going to reach that place. Number two, it's not possible for the blood vessels to go there and see that. The tissue heals. So because these two reasons, we have got to remove all the dead and devitalized tissues till they start bleeding. This is the first part of the debridement. Second part, even before that, we have got to do thorough washing of the, that's known as wound toilet. Wound toilet followed by excision of this. Number one, wound toilet is very, very important, because that itself, the patient's wound may be completely contaminated with, especially if they are road traffic accident or machine or industrial accident, they will all be contaminated with sand, muck, sometimes oil, all those things will be there. So we have got to remove all those things by thorough washing with pressure if possible. Then you go in for excision of all the dead and devitalized tissue. These are the two important steps you have got to think of in debridement. Now, the other things that you have got to think of in compound fractures is, number one, to start with, assess the damage to the skin. Assess the damage to skin. You have got to assess the damage to skin, because early skin cover is the most vital thing for the successful outcome of a compound fracture treatment. Early skin cover, why is this important? Sometimes in the injury, there will not be sufficient skin for them to have regular suturing. You can get the thing together and sutures nicely, but more than 90% of the cases will not be able to do a primary suturing. And if you can't get early skin cover by a primary suturing, what is the alternative? The alternative could be, after assessing the damage, see whether you could get a very good suturing without tension. That's most important. If the suture cannot be achieved, you have got to think of or take help of a plastic surgeon. Then they will decide how to get a skin cover. These types of skin cover that are available, because it's not an orthopedic problem, basic things I'm going to talk to you about. The first thing that they can do is what is known as split thickness skin grafting, SSG. SSG. This is immediately we get a skin cover by taking the donor skin, usually from the opposite thigh, or if possible both the thighs, if the thighs are available for getting the donor area. So this is known as split thickness or superficial skin grafting. And if the patient's condition is fit and if the possibility is there, good things can be planned immediately. Sometimes instead of doing a split thickness grafting, people usually do whole thickness grafting. Having taken care of the skin with the help of plastic surgeon if needed, once we are sure that the skin cover is good enough, we can actually give the primary treatment to the fracture. Primary treatment for fracture by way of internal fixation. But if it is more than 24 to 48 hours, it is always better to avoid a primary fixation of the fracture in case of compound fractures. I repeat, if the delay is more than 24 to 48 hours, better to avoid primary fixation of the fractures. So if you can't do primary fixation, what is the alternative? Alternative is apply plaster, POP slab, use of splints, the best way is to have, if external fixators are ready, external fixators are to be used. These external fixators are very useful for managing a fracture, the advantage being if there is an external fixator, the fracture is almost immobilized nicely. Number one, if needed, the wound can be inspected regularly. Three, if there is a necessity for skin dressing of the wound, then we can do a regular dressing. Then what about injury to the vessels and nerves? We should not wait even a few minutes if there is injury to the vessels. You have got to take the help of a vascular surgeon. What does he do? He usually tries to flush it and repair, or he may do flush the clots and then the what is known as embolectomy he will do. Two, he may do a bypass or you may do a grafting. These are the three basic things we can expect from a vascular surgeon. Why? Because unless we get back the vasculature immediately, the patient may end up in a Hoffman's ischemic contracture, or the limb may become gangrenous, wherein we have got to resort to amputation. So we don't want amputation in all possible cases. If vascular surgeon is available, the best thing you seek is help. He will do an embolectomy and re-establish circulation, or you may do a bypass, or you may do a grafting. And if these three things are only fundamental things, we cannot talk much about all these vascular procedures. The best only to make the people or young orthopedic surgeons that one should not hesitate. If you suspect there is injury to the blood vessels, please do not leave the patient in a small hospital without the efficient management of a vascular surgeon. If you don't have the facilities, please do not hesitate and send the patient to the best possible unit where vascular surgeons are available. So the other problems are injury to the nerves and tendons. Then what to do with the tendons? Primary repair only if the patient comes early. Tendons. Otherwise, if the patient comes late, anchor the ends of the tendon. Anchor ends of tendon with black silk for easy identification, number one, and two, to prevent retraction of the ends of the tendons which are cut. Nerve repair can also be done if the wound is clean and its cut is fresh, clean and fresh. That is, the nerve is there, cut clean like this, and it is fresh. If it is badly lacerated, cut like this, split, or it is badly retracted, don't try to attempt any nerve repair immediately. It is not good. If it is that easy, cut ends are easily visible without any problem like this, we can do it. Suppose the tendons and it is partially cut, you can see the nerve cleanly, we can do a repair. And it must be within first 6 to 12 hours once again. If it is beyond that, better not to attempt any nerve repair. So most of the fractures are treated after the primary debridement, skin cover, or even without skin cover by external fixators nowadays. External or X-fix we call them. This is the most important thing. There are various things are there, and by having these things, excellent fixators, we can almost like magic, the things which are hanging can be treated very nicely by proper excellent fixation. If necessary, bridging a joint also. Suppose a bone is broken below the joint as well as above the joint, you have got fixators which can manage such kind of things also. So it's all ingenuity with which we can have a combination of fixation because of the polyaxial types of external fixators. Polyaxial. We have this, any type of things can be. Once again, this also is a highly difficult, I mean very difficult thing, and unless there's very good experience for one, we should not easily just attempt these external fixators. Better to send it to an institution where people are well versed with these fixators, then only we will have a successful outcome of these fractures.